हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल वन एकेडमी। आई एम सोमेश उपाध्याय, यूपीएससी रैंक 34, आईएएस ऑफिसर इन ओडिशा काडर। दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर इज ऑन गवर्नेंस एंड गुड गवर्नेंस एंड इट इज़ पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नेंस इश्यूज सिलेबस इन द यूपीएससी मेंस जीएस पेपर 2 एंड दिस इज हाई क्वालिटी लेसन सीरीज दैट आई एम मेकिंग फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ यूपीएससी। So let's understand what is government and what is governance. Government is an institutional entity. It means that it is an institution and it is far from citizens. It is closed and complex entity of very powerful persons who approaching whom is very difficult for citizens. That is what the concept of government is. But this concept has been changing since 1980s. Earlier it was डायरेक्ट एंड कंट्रोल, इन द सेंस कि गवर्नमेंट डायरेक्ट करती थी कि सिटीजन्स क्या कर सकते हैं क्या नहीं कर सकते हैं और सिटीजन्स को कंट्रोल करती थी। इट वॉज नॉट अ सर्विस डिलीवरी मोड, इट वॉज मोस्टली पैटर्नलिस्टिक अप्रोच। जैसे माता पिता अपने बच्चों को कंट्रोल करते हैं वैसे गवर्नमेंट कंट्रोल करती थी। बट सिंस 1980s इट स्टार्टेड चेंजिंग इन टू पार्टनर एंड कोलाबरेट, वेयर सिटीजन एंड गवर्नमेंट बोथ आर पार्टनर्स and they collaborate to achieve certain targets. So you see in this cartoon and find out what it means. It basically shows the complexity of the government. Governance on the other hand is the process of decision making and also the process of service delivery. So it is not just institutional concept, it is institutional and networked entity. Networked means networked with different kind of stakeholders. It is partnering with different stakeholders. Who are these stakeholders? These are public sector, which is the government sector, private sector, civil society organizations like NGOs, non-profit organizations, and citizens, including media also. So it is a partner concept, it is a network of institutions. Now governance is no more a monopoly of the government only. Government means the elected and selected executive body or the legislative body or the judiciary body. So this forms the government. Three wings of government are executive, legislative and judiciary. So this government inka monopoly nahi hai, it is now more broad-based in the sense इसका दायरा बढ़ गया है, it includes more people in the governance process. It also means less government and more governance. Less government means as a citizen you will feel less presence of the government officials, you will not be highly dependent on them. Your service will come to you without being dependent, without running to their offices, without begging, without bribing. So that is what less government means and more governance. You get more service delivery with less interface with the actual powerful people in the government. And instead of passive receiver of benefits, now you are active stakeholder. So passive receiver of benefits kaisa tha pehle, government scheme banati thi center mein rehke aur sabko bolte the ki ab tumhe ye milega aur उसमें सिटीज़न कुछ नहीं बोल सकता था कि हमें ये चाहिए हमें ये दो। अभी क्या हो गया है कि एक्टिव स्टेक होल्डर, नाउ गवर्नमेंट इंगेजेस द सिटीजनरी टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट द डिमांड इज एंड अकॉर्डिंगली डिजाइन्स पॉलिसीज एंड स्कीम्स। एंड नाउ गवर्नेंस मीन्स नो माई बाप कल्चर। व्हाट इज माई बाप कल्चर? इट मीन्स अगेन द पैटर्नलिस्टिक अप्रोच वेयर गवर्नमेंट इज माई बाप। इफ यू वॉन्ट्स यू टू फीड ही विल फीड यू, इफ यू वॉन्ट्स यू टू कीप हंग्री ही विल कीप यू हंग्री, बट दैट इज नो मोर। It's now a more participative approach and demand-based, right-based approach where citizens' right is the topmost in governance. Okay, now next we'll learn about what is good governance. Good governance is not a very new concept, friends. Kautilya or Chanakya in his Arthashastra talked about how king should behave. He said, in the happiness of his subjects lies the king's happiness. Their welfare is his welfare. This is such a beautiful definition of good governance. Even Gandhiji, he said, Swaraj should come with Suraj. Suraj means good governance. Now, good governance means basically टू क्रिएट एटमोसफेयर फॉर ऑल सिटीजन्स. नंबर वन, टू रियलाइज देयर फुल पोटेंशियल रिगार्डलेस ऑफ व्हाट क्लास, व्हाट कास्ट, व्हाट जेंडर और व्हाट रिलीजन दे बिलोंग टू. एंड ऑल्सो फॉर सिटीजन्स टू अवेल पब्लिक सर्विस डिलीवरी इफेक्टिवली, एफिशियंटली एंड इन टाइमली मैनर. सो दिस इज वॉट गुड गवर्नेंस इज अबाउट. द गवर्नेंस विच क्रिएट्स सच एटमोसफेयर इज कॉल्ड गुड गवर्नेंस. एंड गुड गवर्नेंस इज ऑल्सो सिटीजन सेंट्रिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. इट इज नो मोर गवर्नमेंट सेंट्रिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. सिटीजन इज एट द सेंटर एंड गवर्नमेंट टेक्स केयर ऑफ द सिटीजन, विच मीन्स इट इज राइट्स बेस्ड अप्रोच वेयर इंस्टेड ऑफ वी गिविंग यू समथिंग, द गवर्नमेंट गिविंग द सिटीजन समथिंग, द सिटीजन डिमांड्स those things as their right. For example, right to information, right to education and National Food Security Act. All these are rights of people. And good governance also focuses more on outputs and very less on outcomes. Now this is very common keyword being used. A lot of people do not understand what is outcome and what is output. Simply understand kariye कि आउटकम का मतलब होता है नंबर्स, फिगर्स, डेटा. आई गेव दिस मैनी इंदिरा आवास योजना टू इंडियन पीपल, 1 लाख पीपल गॉट बेनिफिटेड, इतना पैसा डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हो गया, इतना पैसा एलोकेट हो गया, इतना बजट में दे दिया, इतने लोग बेनिफिट मिल गया, दैट इज आउटकम. बट ऑलवेज गिविंग मनी और गिविंग प्रोजेक्ट और गिविंग इंदिरा आवास योजना ऑन पेपर डज नॉट एक्चुअली मीन कि आउटकम उसका वही हुआ कि वो बंदा जो है ही हैज गॉटन हाउस और हैज गॉटन द मनी और हैज गॉटन द पेंशन. सो आउटपुट मीन्स व्हाट एक्चुअल रियल रिजल्ट देयर इज ऑन द ग्राउंड. सो अर्लियर इट वॉज ओनली आउटकम बेस्ड, नाउ इट इज आउटपुट बेस्ड सिटीजन सेंट्रिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. दैट इज वॉट गुड गवर्नेंस इज अबाउट. नेक्स्ट वी लर्न व्हाट आर द फीचर्स ऑफ गुड गवर्नेंस, व्हाट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ गुड गवर्नेंस. एंड दे आर दिस 8 कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स: कंसेंसस ओरिएंटेड, अकाउंटेबल, ट्रांसपेरेंट, responsive, equitable and inclusive, effective and efficient, and follows the rule of law, and also participatory. We'll briefly understand all the meanings of these words. Number one, consensus oriented. Number one is accountable. Accountable means being answerable to citizens. Citizen can ask you question, what have you done with this project? Why have you not given this, and why this particular problem is not being solved? So these are the answerable mechanism, and that is what accountability is. Second is transparent. Transparent means information is available for access. Jo bhi government mein decision ho raha hai, unless it is very important to keep it secret, it should be available publicly to the citizens, and that is what transparency is about. How is decision being made? Whether it is, if you are awarding a contract to a particular company, whether proper process is followed or not, did you give everyone equal chance to participate in the tender? This kind of things are the indicators of transparency. Next, responsive. What is responsive government? You should address citizens' problem within a reasonable time. Aisa nahi ki aaj aavedan kiya aur 10 saal baad you are trying to solve his problem. You should solve his problem as and when the problem arises. Next is equitable and inclusive, which means you should care for vulnerable sections and do not show any fear or favor towards anyone, but there has to be extra care for the vulnerable sections who are marginalized in the society. Next feature is effective and efficient. Effective means it should produce result. That is what effective is. If you are effective, you'll be able to give out results. If somebody is an effective bowler, he should be able to take wickets. That is what effectiveness means. And what is efficiency? Efficiency means minimum resources use karke aapko wo kaam achieve karna hai. That is what efficiency is. So this concept should be very clear to you, my friends, and these are the keywords that you should use in your answers. Next is the good governance. In good governance, government should follow the rule of law. Rule of law means law is supreme. Whatever law says, accordingly things will be done. People cannot, just because you are the ruler or the administrator, does not mean you can do as per your own whims and fancies. Otherwise, what will happen? If there is no rule of law, there will be मत से न्याय मीन्स स्मॉलर फिश विल बी ईटन बाय बिगर फिश एंड देर विल बी केओस इन द सोसाइटी. दैट इज वाई रूल ऑफ लॉ इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नेक्स्ट इज पार्टिसिपेटरी. दिस फीचर मीन्स दैट पीपल शुड बी एबल टू वॉइस देयर ओपिनियन, बी पार्टिसिपेटिव इन द सेंस देयर इनपुट शुड बी कंसिडर्ड वाइल टेकिंग एनी डिसीजन और डिजाइनिंग एनी स्कीम. दिस इज वॉट पार्टिसिपेटरी गवर्नेंस मीन्स. एंड ऑल्सो लिसनिंग टू देयर ग्रीवांसेस. एंड फाइनली कंसेंसस ओरिएंटेड. ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर्स ऑफ द गवर्नेंस, मीडिया, डिफरेंट पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज, ऑपोजिशन, गवर्नमेंट, सिविल सोसाइटी ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, एवरीबडी शुड बी टेकन ऑन बोर्ड टू टेक अ डिसीजन. एंड देर शुड बी सम कॉमन मिनिमम एजेंडा. कॉमन मिनिमम मीन्स इट शुड बी एग्रीएबल टू एवरी वन. दैट इज द कॉमन टू ऑल. सो दीज आर द फीचर्स ऑफ गुड गवर्नेंस. नेक्स्ट वी विल लर्न वॉट आर द फोर पिलर्स ऑफ गुड गवर्नेंस. दीज आर ऑल्सो फोर ईज ऑफ गुड गवर्नेंस बिकॉज यू विल सी ऑल द वर्ड्स स्टार्ट विद ई. नंबर वन इज एथोस. Ethos is what? The orientation towards service of the citizens, the public officers, the public servants, civil servants, the government, the ministers, everyone, their orientation should be towards delivering service to the citizens. Second is ethics. Ethics means honesty, integrity and transparency. You all understand what honesty is? Integrity means you are being honest even when somebody is not watching you. That is what integrity is. And transparency is very clear to you. Next pillar is equity. Equity means non-discrimination and empathy for the weaker section. You will not discriminate on the basis of the citizen's caste, class, gender or religion or any other identifier. You will treat all citizens equally, but you should also take care of the weaker sections. You should have more empathy for the weaker sections because they are the most vulnerable people in the society. And the final fourth pillar of good governance is efficiency. If your government is not efficient, there is no good governance. What is efficiency? Speedy and effective service delivery without any harassment of any people. Simple. Now what you see here are some of the examples of good governance measures. For example, RTI, right to information. GST was implemented to simplify the taxation process. Mo Sarkar scheme in Odisha is to make public officials answerable to the citizens. And there have been so many steps taken by the government of India to improve the ease of doing business in India. And you can see the results have been tremendous. There is Bhumi scheme in Karnataka, which has been appreciated for simplifying the land rights process. Buying land, purchasing land, owning land, selling land, all this process has been digitized and eased out with the Bhumi. And then Digital India, you all know about. These are some of the examples of good governance. Now, one of the key features of good governance is citizen participation. How can citizens participate in governance? Number one is by seeking information. Seeking information happens through RTI. People can file application RTI karke. They can ask for certain kind of information in the government. And also the government should voluntarily disclose it. Apne website pe they should put all the data which can be disclosed to public so that there is no need of somebody filing an RTI. And that is a very good practice in good governance. Second process is giving suggestion. Citizen is no more a passive body just sitting there and receiving benefits from the government, not saying anything, not demanding anything and not giving suggestion. Now people, citizens should give suggestion and government should listen to citizens continuously, not only during election time but all the time. This should be a continuous process. There is another process of taking suggestion from citizen, which is surveys, referendum, where you can ask people to vote on a particular issue, and also it helps in finding local solutions because the person who faces the problem is the best person to give solutions to, hai na? So that is why if you listen to public, you will get you will find the solutions also. Next is demand better service. citizens should never be satisfied with its government. It should always constantly demand better and better delivery service, so that the governance process, because it is evolving, it keeps improving. Unless you demand more, the government is reluctant to give you more. That is why you should always demand better service from the government. You shouldn't be satisfied. For example, Mo Sarkar initiative in the government of Odisha has been initiated by the government to let people demand better service from the government. Next way of participation is participating in decision making. People should negotiate for better policies and better projects. If you see, there are some in some places, like in Bangalore, there was a proposal of building a steel bridge, and it was very costly for the government, and people were aware, so they protested against it. They wanted better projects, they want better policies. Okay, then there are another ways of participating, like municipal budgeting. In some municipalities, what they do, they take feedback from the people, what they want in the budget, and that is called participatory municipal budgeting. There are public hearings in many places before project approval, especially in Gram Sabha. You will see there are in many project there is a law where 80% of the Gram Sabha has to agree on a particular project, and then only that can be approved and gone ahead with it. So that is example of participatory governance and participation of citizens in decision making. And finally, the citizen should always hold the government accountable, whether it's through feedback or generating a report card, citizens report card, or doing a social audit. For example, MNREGA, in many of the states there has been addition of social audit feature, where the whatever work is done is audited in front of public, and public can give their opinion whether that work was done or not, or whether they got their wages or not. So all this can be done. Next, we'll learn about accountability in government, in governance, which is very important part of governance. Without accountability, there is no good governance. Accountability means what? That the government is answerable for its actions, for its decisions, and it cannot go scot-free. Okay, accountability is a little bit different from answerability. Answerability means just that the government is bound to answer, but is not bound for being penalized. Accountability has that penalty factor, that if you do not perform well, not only will ask you questions, if you're found to be not performing well or doing unscrupulous things, then you will also be penalized. That is what accountability is. And civil servants and they are accountable to political executives and also the citizens, directly by political executive and indirectly by citizens. Political executives, they are accountable to legislature and directly to citizens also, because they have to go to vote. Why accountability mechanisms are needed? Because you see, accountability in government is very complex. Nobody wants to be held accountable. They want it. It gives a more sense of power if you are not accountable to anyone. So there is general reluctance in the government to be accountable by itself. So there has to be set up a mechanism, and this mechanism is needed because accountability, taking accountability from the government, is very complicated. And there are two types of mechanism. One is within the state. Within the state means state ke andar hi kuch bodies bane hue hain jo accountability ensure karte hain. And they are called horizontal mechanism. Why horizontal? Because same level pe hai, government mein hi hai wo. Second type is outside the state, which is outside the state, and it is called vertical mechanism, which means it is outside the state, so it's a different bodies altogether, and that's why it's called vertical mechanism. Let's see what are the vertical accountability mechanism, which is outside the state. There are certain high impact mechanisms like elections and RTI Act. Through RTI Act, people can ask questions, and there have been many good RTI applications which have unearthed many scams. And the elections are also very high impact accountability mechanisms, because people have to, the ministers, the parliamentarians, the MLAs and MPs, they have to go back to citizens and get their vote. So that is a very high impact mechanism. There are low impact mechanisms like civil society organizations which can ask questions to the government. There is mainstream media and social media, both criticize the government and ask for more information, more clarity, better policies and better projects and schemes. And there is a low to medium impact mechanism which is called citizen charter, and we will learn about citizen charter separately in the next lecture. Finally, we come to the horizontal accountability mechanism. Horizontal मतलब मैंने क्या बताया था कि same level पे, मतलब within the government that mechanism is created. And you see these all bodies are within the government. How? Now within the government it can be outside the executive or within the executive. Executive क्या है? Like I told you, governance has three parts: executive, legislative and judiciary. Executive is the one who executes all the schemes and laws and policies. So there are certain bodies which are outside these executives and they're called parliament, the judiciary, CAG, comptroller and auditor general, and lokayukta. Lokayukta mein you can, anybody can complain about any kind of corruption, and the lokayukta can himself or herself take cognizance of any kind of corruption. And central business commission, which is another body which keeps watch on the government functionaries. आपने सुना होगा विजिलेंस का रेड हो गया, इट्स ऑल दैट पार्ट ऑफ मैकेनिज्म फॉर अकाउंटेबिलिटी. एंड देन विद इन द एग्जीक्यूटिव क्या क्या तरीके हैं? विद इन द एग्जीक्यूटिव देर आर सुपीरियर ऑफिसर्स. इफ आई एम एन ऑफिसर, माई सुपीरियर ऑफिसर विल बी एबल टू राइट माई परफॉर्मेंस रिपोर्ट PAR, एंड ही कैन ऑल्सो टेक डिसिप्लिनरी एक्शंस इफ देर इज एनी मिसचीफ डन बाई मी. एंड देर इज ऑल्सो परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम which is digitized, where you can enter, where there can be 360 degree evaluation. All your juniors and seniors can evaluate you, or it can be even just evaluation by your senior who will write your performance report. Then another type of within the executive bodies are CBI, police, the internal audit mechanism. Every department has internal auditors who first see the project proposal and audit it and then vet it. And there are grievance redressal mechanism within the system, where people can come with the grievances and those will be addressed within the system. This is a part of governance and good governance. Friends, you don't need to read any other books apart from this lecture. Please come back and revise, and like this video, share this video with other aspirants, and subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to come with many more free high quality lessons for you for UPSC syllabus. Thank you.